20 points for Manta style. First, good versus melee heroes, they can't know which one are you. Enemy carry will need to right click your correct hero again, which escalates into him doing less right clicks. Second point, good for heroes that benefit with illusions thanks to their spells, like Phantom Lancer, Manta Illusions creates another illusions, Terror Blade combo with Meta, Luna with her passive bounces, and some other rare ones like Anti-Mage Mana Burning combo and others. Third point, combo with items, Radiant Spires, it burns, so it can be used as farming tool, shoving lane tool while your hero is in safety of jungle nearby. Side note, I don't recommend it mostly doing it without radiance, of like putting illusions on the lanes, killing creeps, since the active of Manta is just too valuable and cooldown too long, and can save you in many cases if you like keep it. And illusions kill waves poorly without some mechanics such as radiance. And also mana cost of Manta is too high in order to get 1-2 creeps. Fourth point, another Manta is like cheaper version of BKB or some dodging surviving item. If it's enough for you to not die in fight, go for it instead of buying BKB. Fifth point, how to recognize if it's enough. Good to know what it can purge, since Manta is mainly purchased for the reasons of purging stuff from your dodging stuff. Sixth point, it dodges all sorts of projectiles, meaning anything that flies, like Vengeful Stun. She throws it while it's traveling to you, you click Manta, so it's important to recognize animations of spells, of how heroes look like when they cast stuff on you. That will make your reaction times way faster, fast enough to dodge it naturally. Also, what helps is imagining that if he's there, his best place to stun you, so you can preemptively prepare to hover over button where your Manta is, being ready to press it anytime soon. 7 points, so projectiles dodge, yes, and also mostly single target spells like lifesteal or open wounds. And another thing what it does, 8 point, also it can jebait those spells enemy has that has longer animation, so it forces them to recast it again, like Luna Q has big animation, even Patch Ult has animation, and if we count his turn rate, it's gonna take him a while before he can ult your proper hero. Especially if he's for some reason not expecting it, because he's not thinking actively about Game of Dota while he plays. He's gonna have his brain delayed, and you can make a lot of more hits, right clicks on him before he realizes that he should like ult you again. Or 9 point, it's counter to Orchid and all sorts of silences like silence ult, all sorts of roots, etc. The Orchid counter is big deal, especially for heroes that doesn't want to buy BKBs. Which heroes doesn't want to buy BKBs? Well, those who already have built-in BKB mechanism. Because if you're forced to buy BKB for a hero that already has BKB, like Juggernaut, Lifestealer, etc., then two buttons of yours are doing same job, so you losing opportunity to be powerful in your other weaknesses your hero has. It's like buying, let's say, two Orchids, and or hitting one guy that dodges it with like one item or spell. It's just like not worth. It's almost pointless waste of gold, making you weaker than you have to. And you would rather have a different solution to the problem, such as item that will fix it and also gives you stats or other cool stuff, than just few strength stats that BKB has and provides. Which is nothing to compare to like what Manta gives you. And both are like very similar cost. 10th point, don't buy it on heroes that naturally dodge stuff for the same reasons as why you don't want usually to have two things that does the same thing. So example of that can be like Slark with Manta seems awkward because he purchased stuff with Q. So like buying two things that does the same stuff will like make him just like, should I choose pressing Q or should I choose Manta? Well, I can do both any of those and it will do the same thing. So I just like wasted some gold. I could have had some different item. Because like my Q is already powerful, very very powerful enough to do the same job. So I would so like anything in Dota, I would there are like very rarely I would buy like Manta on Slark. There are also always some exceptions, but yes, in everything in Dota, but usually you shouldn't buy it there. So mainly you buy Manta, for example, when you for the Orchid dodge, or and when you're sure you don't need BKB. 11th point, Manta is natural build for Yasha users. Yasha is good for farming and scaling and helps people that don't need any other item right now. 12th point, some fact. Usually people decide between Manta or Ascension Yasha because they are both components that builds from Yasha. And then again, how to know which one to go for, it's for like longer talk, but simplistically, Manta is cooler BKB choice if you don't need BKB to survive, and Yasha is like good for status resistance, nicely comboing with Satanic, so all spells and stuff thrown at you last shorter time. So when you have like small, when you have small stuff that you don't need to purge immediately, etc., it might be a good choice. So, small stuff that you not don't need. To purge immediately, it might be a good choice to like go for Ascension Yasha, like undodgeable or very hard dodgeable stance, slows, etc. Like let's say Bloodseeker ult, Axe Call, for example, that's a good one where people buy Ascension Yasha against, so it lasts shorter time. Usually, the stuff that you won't dodge with Manta nor BKB saves you from it or counters it. 13th point makes you invulnerable, untargetable for a brief moment. If you read the description of the Manta, it's like 0.1 second right now. So very skilled players can abuse it by dodging key spells in proper times, like I don't know, Disruptor Glimpse or Magnus Ultimate without actually being stunned. And some other cool techniques like getting out of some spells like Shaker Q, etc., or scouting for you with illusions that provides vision, putting it in rush pit or on high ground to get vision of areas, debating opponents by macroing illusions to all sides. So when you're like running away, they don't know which illusion illusion they should chase for. And which is the true hero. Debating key spells by sending unexpected illusions on lane and baiting chronospheres and all sorts of other spells. But all those things can be marked as like too professional and can't be much generalized into saying you're gonna like use it in every game. And most of them just slows you down if you try to apply them or kills you if you try them. So like don't do debates of illusions to bait Chronos or whatever in every game. Don't try to do it intentionally because like it's just a waste of time. It requires specific moments in order to have like logical sense to do it and some calculations. Like simplistically said, I can say that it's only worth if you know if enemy won't favor it, that it's still best play you could have done with your time. Such as you having no option to do anything else than this with your time. It's just a detail in grand scheme of brackets and skills in Dota. It's usually not the reason to buy Manta in first place. It's just a bonus. Okay, 14 point. Using it when you're low HP will escalate into illusions dying fast since they copy your HP. 15 point. Beware of having enough mana since 125 mana is not a joke, especially versus like mana burning heroes. 16. First, build Yasha over Ultimate Orb for the reasons of what's your job. Is it to be tankier with 10 stats on Ultimate Orb, or is it to farm faster? Answer is gonna be Yasha. Especially when you were considering to buying like components, like items from it, like Sentient Yasha or Manta. 17. Sometimes purchasing Yasha on yourself and then putting recipe on courier and sending it to secret shop is the fastest way to get your Manta. 18. Having bind Manta illusions to buttons separately might be cool. Professional move, useful mainly as Radiant heroes. Personally, you don't have to use it to be like fast, still fast at it, but yeah, it's one small thing that can be improved if you're like playing Radiant heroes a lot. Some natural builders 19. Some natural builders based on spells can be Anti-Mage, Terrorblade, Luna, PL, Wraith King, Faceless Void, Doozah. Some natural builders based on like anti-orc hit, counter, anti-dodge spells and items can be Morphling, Troll, Warlock, Troll. Yeah, and almost like any PA, any like carry. Based on Radiance, it can be Spectre Alchemist, Lifesteal, Wraith King, for example. And some also I wrote down some heroes to think twice if you're gonna purchase it or not or on them because they are just not comboed well with the Manta itself. Like the damage doesn't like the they have no spell to much combo it with. Can be like Slark, Sven, Urza, Gyrocopter, Bloodseeker, Weaver, Razor, Monkey King, Lynx. Those heroes don't combo it with Manta super well. For reasons they have also their own like escaping mechanism. So like building the same thing twice would be awkward. Or like they require like they require BKB because they for example like standing their own ground like Monkey King casts ultimate and if you like buy only like Manta on him it might be like not enough but yeah like since he cannot like walk away from his ult anyways he wants to like stay there on it. So side note, these heroes that I mentioned, they can like buy Manta like multifunctionally, like for all the reasons, not just because it's Radiance user. Maybe you just want to like dodge the orc hit as well as using it as farming tool for Radiance users. So 20 point. Just some tip is just like to read what it gives you, like the text and even the text that only shows when you press the alt. Like the invulnerability seconds stats all can be like useful to like decide if you want that item or not compared to the other items. And and side note to that is like every hero usually needs some farming potential in early game, so that's why those small items exist. So if your hero is like Yasha user, you might be more inclined into upgrading that Yasha later on. Example of that can be I can like buy a diffusal on Slark and still use it as farming tool, or drums, or Echo Saber, Madness, or whatever, and even Yasha, but since I don't benefit much from Manta as Slark, since I have the Q, I would only consider Yasha as my farming item if I'm like considering sentient Yasha. And let's say like Drow, on the other hand, like would I buy Diffuse on Drow? Probably not. Like it doesn't, mana burn works differently, and the active will not be probably used because your goal is to be far away from people, and the active only works on like small radius around her. But does she combo with farming items such as Yasha? Of course, she does. Like she benefits from any agility she's given on her thanks to her ultimates. Gives her more damage. Okay, that's it about Manta style.